atvažiavom aštuoniese. Labai gerai, kad priešininkas irgi buvo aštuoniese. Tai, nu, iš tikro, nes, nu, ir turim rūpešių su Ignu, su Julium, tai yra iš visų sudėtinga situacija ten. O tai buvo neramu, tiesiog fiziškumu. Nu, ta prasme, jeigu priešininkai vat, būtų pradėję bėgti, jeigu jie 10, jie vien galėjo, tai tokiam greitom atakom mus būtų tiesiog, nu, nėra rotacijos. Tai buvo neramu, bet kada ir pas juos 8, tai kaip ir viskas normaliai, tos jėgos išsilygino, tai ir žaidėjai tą krepšinį, kažkaip panašiai gavosi, tai bent jau, kaip čia, žmogus viršui kažkiek aplygino, jokių būdų čia nesidžiaugiu kažkokiam traumom ar dar kažkuo priešininku, jokių būdų, neduok dėvė čia niekam, bet sakykim taip, o, nu ką, mes žinojom, kad jie gali kabintis ir rungtynės, pamatęs aš jų sudėtį, supratau, kad gali kabintis tik tritaškais. Tai, nu, mes taip gal ten porą epizodų praleidom, kur rankas nuleidom ir į veidą įmetė porą tritaškių, tai kvaila buvo, aišku, ten pirmavom, kontroliavom rungtynės, negaliu pykti ant vyrų, iš karto atsiranda šiek tiek atsipalaidavimas, nu čia, ir gavom to keletą tritaškių, bet šiaip, man atrodo, mes visai neblogai sukontroliavom, jo, 18% pas juos, tai ten reikėjo tą Kalacakį laikyti ir Tamulį, kurį jie gali padaryti tą persvarą, sakykim, tie du žmonės. Nu, be abejo, tą patį ten Vylį. Tai, manau, šitos dalykus išsprendėm. Tai dėl to buvom ramiai rungtynėse, sakyčiau.
Ar po šitos pergalės jau yra, sakykim, jausmas komandoje, kad COVID-o pauzė yra praeity, ar tas fiziškumas grįžta žaidėjams?
Jo, tai ačiū Dievui, išėjom be traumų. Visai neblogai bėgom vienu metu, bet tik tai be galvos. Tai reiškiasi, fizinė ta kondicija, jinai sugrįžo, reiškia, noras bėgti ir tempuoti po geros gynybos yra, tik tai dar, aišku, kokybės reikia. Kaip mes tą darom, tai dar čia va dar klausimai ir čia, aišku, šnekėsim, turim ką veikti, labai geros rungtynės šituo požiūriu, bet be jokios abejonės, tai jau žymiai lengviau žmonės. Sakykime, aštuonies atlaikė, jie irgi jauni vyrukai lakstė pirmin, gal kovotojai geri, ten Kazakauskas ištisai su Čepukaičiu ten terorizuoja, reikėjo atverti, smuštą kamulį, tai, nu, yra, ypatingai jie turėjo tą priekinę liniją, kur mes neturėjom, sakykime, buvom, bet mes, aišku, kitus pranašumus turėjom. Taip, mes grįžtam, mes jau, manau, kad dar pasijungs Ignas ir bus labai, labai neblogai.
Vaido Kariniausko debiutas jūsų vadovaujamoje komandoje. Kaip vertinat patį debiutą ir kiek naudos potencialiai gali atnešti Kariniausko prisijungimas prie komandos?
Tai jau imdami mes jį, sakykim, kad atsirado galimybę jį paimti. Tiesiog mes šiandien tikrai nesiruošėm imti būtinai iš Nevėžio ar dar kažkas, bet tiesiog, kad atsirado galimybę ir jisai pats parodė norą didžiulį pas mus ateiti. Tai aš mačiau, koks tai lygio, galų gale mes visi žinojom prieš tai, kokio tai lygio žaidėjas, tik tai jo nebuvo Lietuvoje, ten buvo įvairios apie jį tos istorijos, sakykime, prieš istorijos visos, tai, nu, bet kada matosi žmogus atsidavęs tam krepšiniu, dabar iki taip čia, koks čia posakis labiausiai tiktų, iki kaulų smegenų ten, kaip sakoma, tai nekylo abejonės, jis reikalingas vėl, pasikartosiu, todėl, kad mums labai reikėjo, na, sakykime, suteikti metikam situacijas, kurios mes turim, kaip šiandien, sakykime, matės, iš karto atskleisti juos, lygiai taip pat dideliem numesti kamulį, kada reikia, mes, na, nu, silpnai gavosi, sakykime, ta mūsų, tas tandemas, taip, mes nelaimėjom tas rungtynės, tas, kurias reikia, aš negaliu pykti, pralaimėjom ten gal Žalgiriui, Rytui, bet, nu, norisi to žaidimo tokio, nu, rimtesnio, solidesnio, tai pas Bryantą ir pas Marių, nu, ir pats Marius sako, ne, treneri, man geriau vis dėlto atakuojančių, nu, ir supratau, kad reikia priimti šitą sprendimą, ieškoti geriau ne trečio, kur aš norėjau padidinti ūgį, sakykime, komandoj, tą, sakykime, fiziškumą ir visą kitą, bet supratau, kad vis dėlto reikalingas žaidėjas tos pauzės metu, tai gerai, kad pavyko Vaidą atrasti, sakykime, ir gerai, kad pavyko jį, na, paimti, taip sakykime. Tai taip, tai yra geras žaidėjas, aš, jeigu jisai laikys tokį tempą, aišku, dar yra, jis atėjo, sakykime, padarė jis ten tų mūsų strateginių, nes čia viską taip greitai perprasti per savaitę, kad ir jam jis labai protingas, imlus, bet kada jisai viską supras taip, kaip mes norim žaisti, tai bus, nu, tikrai, aš manau, kad jisai dabar net galėtų pretenduoti labai, labai ramiai ir Lietuvos rinktinės žaidėjo poziciją, tikrai.
First, I'll just start by saying, you know, I'm very proud of our guys because I thought we really, really battled. I mean, it wasn't a pretty game. It was, you know, it was definitely kind of an ugly game. You know, we went 5 for 27 from three, which is 18%. If, you know, if we'd have made a couple more of those threes, I thought that was one of the ways we might be able to, you know, steal a win. Obviously, Karina, you know, leaving our team averaging 18 a game, leading the league in scoring, and then joining their team, you know, this is a major thing because it took a lot away from our offense. And tonight, you know, we were playing without Cedric Bearfield, our point guard, who had 19 last game. And actually, even though we didn't play good last game and we lost, he was one of the only guys in double figures. So tonight it hurt us, you know, not to have both those guys. You know, we just had trouble scoring. We really had to try to labor and manufacture baskets. Obviously, you got to give credit, you know, to Juventus. They're a veteran team. You know, the coach did a good job. The last thing I'll say that I'm proud of is, you know, they couldn't pull away from us. We kept it at 10-12 because we battled. We played so hard. We out-rebounded them by 10. Again, it was kind of an ugly game, but I think we played really, really hard, and that was the reason why, you know, it didn't turn into 20 or 30. At the same time, you got to give them credit because we couldn't get it down to 2 or 4 or 6 where we could maybe try to be in the game the last 3-4 minutes and maybe try to steal it. So my whole thing that I kept fighting and grinding uphill the whole night was to try to get within like 5 or 6 points and then maybe, because we're at home, maybe steal it at the end. But again, you know, our guys played really hard. We had foul trouble hurt us. We only had one point guard, Domitas, and he had, you know, quick 2 fouls. He had 3 fouls. He had 4 fouls. So, you know, he's a guy that probably would have played 35, 39 minutes, and he only played 26 minutes. Tomulis, I'm very proud of because he came into the game being a 2-man and a 3-man. He has not played 1 minute of point guard the whole year. And in this game today, he played 39 minutes, and he literally played the point almost the whole game. So that showed you, you know, how much character Tomulis played with. You know, so again, there was a lot of positive things to point to. Obviously, you know, no moral victories. A loss is still a loss. So, you know, you got to give credit to Juventus. They're, you know, they're a good team. They're a veteran team. This league is a hard league. If, you know, if you're not clicking on all cylinders, it can be very difficult to score because everybody does a good job in this league defensively. Everybody scouts real well. They know your stuff, and they make it difficult to score. And we just haven't we didn't have enough answers offensively.
So, Coach, you have a vast amount of experience in the collegiate level, and this was the first game for you in Europe as a head coach.
Yes.
How can you compare the similarities and differences between the two play styles of the NCAA and here in Lithuania?
No, it's a very good question. I would say that, you know, the league here, the LKL, it's, you know, it's kind of like a 40-minute chess match, and, you know, and obviously it's much different than the G League or the NBA because of and even I coached in China where they play a 48-minute game, and there's not great defense being played in that league, the CBA, so people are playing 120 to 118. This league is, as I was saying, it's really hard to score, and they don't have the 3-second defensive rule like in the NBA and the G League. So here, everybody clogs the lane. You know, when you get in the paint, it's physical, you know, and there's a lot of help defense. The other part is it's probably the most similar to U.S. in terms of college basketball, as you mentioned, which I coached 18 years. So it's similar. So I, you know, I'm comfortable with that part of it because it's a 40-minute game. You know, the 3-point line, a lot of the tactics are very similar to college basketball in the U.S. But again, the thing that's different is I think that in the U.S., people play a little faster, a little more athletic, a little more up-tempo. And here, again, it's a little more of a half-court, you know, very, you know, IQ from the neck up, really smart, you know, kind of a chess match, as I mentioned, you know, possession by possession. And, you know, guys do a great job in this league. They kind of grind you, you know, they kind of grind you 2x2, 2x2. And so that's, but I think in the long run, it's going to help me as a coach. I think it was a really good experience. I mean, obviously we were surprised when, you know, coach stepped down this past week. It came as a surprise, and we had a lot of drama, a lot of emotions. So we had to, you know, my job and our job, Sarunas, the assistant coach, who also did a great job tonight defensively with helping me and everything. He does all the scouting. our job was basically to try to keep the team together, get us pumped up. You know, we only had 24 hours. We really couldn't put in anything new. We had to just stay with what we knew and just try to get the guys and rally together and come out and play hard. And they did that. So, you know, they kind of did it. They did everything we asked them to do. So, you know, I got to take my hat off to our players and just say we're proud of them, even though, you know, it's still a loss and it feels, you know, we're kind of frustrated. We wish we could have won the game, but I'm proud of how they responded because, again, we only had one day and it wasn't easy to come out and play with all the different changes. First we lose Karina, then Cedric hurts his ankle, coach sits, you know, steps down, and then we only have eight guys, you know, going into the game, eight, nine guys, and then, of course, foul trouble. And then I think at the end we finally got exhausted. Guys just kind of ran out of gas, you know?
You mentioned being surprised by Coach Kiltanovic stepping down, so I would assume that you did not expect at any point to become the head coach of this team during this season. But now that you have assumed this role, at least as a temporary head coach, would you be interested in retaining the head coaching position for the rest of the season?
Well, I mean, you know, I didn't look at it like that. You know, I was very honest with management and the ownership, and I'm appreciative that they believed in me enough to let me take over the team even temporarily. I think that, you know, the fact that it's my first year coaching in Europe, you know, I mean, I don't want to speak for them. It's their decision certainly to figure out if they want to go outside and hire a foreign coach or somebody from Lithuania or a more experienced coach from the EuroLeague. You know, that will be their decision. But I told them from the day I got here, even with Marius as the assistant, that I've been a head coach and I've been an assistant coach. And I knew what I came here for. You know, the role I came to be in was, you know, help the not just the foreign guys, but that was my biggest thing was player development with the guys that are out. Actually, the main three guys I came to work with, Cedric Bearfield, Abramo Sanka, and Ariel Huckporty. They're not playing yet, so I feel sort of bad about that. It would have been nice to have those three guys as a head coach, but so I'll be very happy with whatever happens, even if I coach just temporarily a couple games and they hire a new head coach and I go back to my role that I was in. It's fine. It's kind of what I came here, what I expected. And I didn't come here really thinking that, you know, I want to be the head coach of the team. I came here to get, you know, international experience on my resume. And, you know, that's what I'm doing. And again, certainly getting thrown in the fire is good. But at the same time, I can handle pressure. One thing I had in the past was I was under pressure in the metropolitan area, you know, being from a city like New York, you deal with a ton of media, you know, newspapers, radio, TV. So I coached in those conferences where, you know, there was a lot of pressure. So the pressure part is no big deal. And, you know, I just wanted to do a good job so that the owners and the management came tonight, and hopefully, even though we lost, they walked away saying, well, you know, coach kept the team together and he got them to play hard and it was competitive. And, you know, that was my biggest thing. I wanted to, you know, put the good product out there and have our guys show up and do a good job.